Hey everyone, Teo here. Today I'm going to review the Lenovo ThinkPad X12 detachable. First of all, a disclaimer, this is a review unit on loan from Lenovo. So this is a two-in-one device where you can use it as a laptop or you can detach the keyboard and use it as a tablet. And this supports pen input, but this is sold separately. From what I can see on Lenovo's website, it seems like this device is targeted at business users and or office workers. And since this device supports pen input, I'm quite interested to find out how good it is when it comes to drawing on it. By the way, my review may be a bit long, so if you want to save time, you can check out the text review that I have already written on my blog. The link will be in the video description below. Right, let me give you the bottom line up front. This is a very compact, very portable design. The build quality is excellent. It's very solid. It comes with the keyboard cover. And the keyboard is fantastic. It's really nice to type on. The kickstand is very convenient. There is a fingerprint sensor and fingerprint unlock is very fast. So this is powered by the Intel 11th Gen processor, and together with 8 gigs of RAM, the overall performance when it comes to booting up, opening a lot of apps, a lot of tabs, switching between apps, saving big files, downloading web pages, downloading stuff, all that is going to be very smooth and lag-free. The drawing performance, unfortunately, is not that great, but when it comes to writing, it actually performs like really well. It has excellent handwriting and note-taking performance. Colors on this 12.3-inch display look good out of the box. I measured color support for 99% sRGB and a maximum brightness of 322 nits. So this is a bright display. As for the downsides, the audio quality for the front-facing speakers is not that great. It sounds a bit hollow to me. The pen is not included. There is no micro SD card slot. Those are the three main downsides. In terms of pricing, the pricing is actually quite competitive compared to other devices with similar form factor, such as the Microsoft Surface Pro 7. However, please bear in mind that the keyboard cover is included. The price includes 3-year on-site warranty with the option to upgrade to 5 years, and if you want to, you can upgrade it to next business day repair warranty. They have a lot of options for warranty and servicing. The upgrade pricing for the RAM and storage is also very reasonable. So in terms of value for money, this device, the ThinkPad X12 detachable, does provide good value for money. These are the specifications for this review unit that I have here. So this is running the 11th Gen Intel i7 processor with 4 cores at 2.2 GHz. It has 16 gigs of RAM and 512 gigs of storage. The items included with this device is this USB-C charger. What I have here is a 45-watt charger. From what I've read online, it seems to come with a 60-watt charger. So with this, I was able to charge the tablet in under 2 hours. A 60-watt charger is obviously going to charge this much faster. The battery life for this Intel i7 model is around 7 hours when I'm using this at 50% brightness. From what I have read online, with the Intel i5 processor, you can get up to 9 hours. So if you need more battery life, perhaps go with the Intel i5 instead of the i7. The performance difference is probably not going to be that different, especially when it comes to doing office type work. The keyboard cover is included, and this is quite thick in a good way because this feels like a proper keyboard. The keys are standard size keys. The layout for the keys look all right. Do note the function key is at the bottom left instead of the control button. So with my other keyboards, it's the other way around. There is a dedicated print screen button here. The page up and page down buttons are here. Home and end buttons are here. This is the fingerprint sensor. And there is this very recognizable track point. There is good key travel. There is nice response and feedback. You can definitely speed type on this with no issues. The overall typing experience is excellent. The fingerprint sensor unlock is quite quick. There's also face unlock, but it's not as reliable compared to the fingerprint sensor. The trackpad is medium size, has good accuracy. There is left click here and right click here, and also three buttons here. This keyboard cover is extremely well built. The build quality is solid. There is no flex at all. This is not Bluetooth, so you cannot use this wirelessly, and it attaches to the bottom of the tablet using magnets here. The ThinkPad logo here has this red light which will pulsate when the tablet is sleeping or when it's charging, and this light will pulsate at the same frequency as the power button above. The sides are flat and these are holes for the air intake. There are actually fans inside. That's the power button at the top. Grills for the exhaust. The corners are rounded off and the edges here have a slight bevel, so this is not sharp. There's a latch here to open the stand, and the hinge is quite stiff, so this will allow you to deploy the stand at various angles. This is the lowest angle possible. This is almost flat. Those are the volume buttons. On this side, we have two USB-C ports. This is a Thunderbolt 4 with USB 3.2. This is a 3.5mm audio jack. And at the bottom here, we have an optional SIM card tray. And this is another USB-C port. This is USB 3.2. This is used for charging. The Thunderbolt port cannot be used for charging. The build quality is excellent. It's very solid and it's very easy to lift this up because the sides are tilted slightly. The weight is 840 grams. Together with the keyboard cover, it's 1.2 kg. And together with the keyboard cover, this is 1.5 centimeters. The cutting and the finishing of the keyboard cover matches the tablet perfectly. Oh, by the way, the fans, they thankfully are not that noisy. This is a 12.3 inch display with a resolution of 1920 by 1280, so the aspect ratio is 3:2, which is nice. The bezels give you enough space for you to hold with your fingers. The bezels are slightly thicker at the top and bottom. The camera here has a privacy shutter, so you can use this to block the camera. This combination of screen size and resolution means there will be slight pixelation. This is still a very usable resolution for work. I have no issues with this resolution on this screen size. The colors on this tablet look great out of the box. I measured color support for 99% sRGB and 76% Adobe RGB, so color accuracy is quite good. And viewing angles are really good as well. The colors don't shift much when you view from different angles. This is how reflective the display is. There is actually anti-reflective coating applied on top. Just for comparison purposes, this is how reflective my phone is compared to the tablet. This is nice because this allows you to still see the content behind the reflection. And this is a bright display, so the brightness is actually more than adequate to go through the reflections. The display is laminated, so there is no gap between the glass and the LCD beneath. So when you're writing or drawing, it seems like the line is appearing directly beneath the pen tip. Here you can see the lines are a bit wobbly. That's why I say this tablet is not that good for drawing. But for writing, it performs really well. Handwriting and note-taking performance is excellent. Here I'm using Microsoft OneNote, and this is able to capture my handwriting rather accurately. Latency is not really an issue when it comes to writing or drawing. The tablet supports two styluses, the Lenovo Digital Pen, which is the one that I have here, and the Lenovo Precision Pen. Both pens are not included and are sold separately. Both pens support pressure sensitivity, with the Lenovo Precision Pen that also supports tilt sensitivity. So the build quality of the Lenovo Digital Pen, it's well built, excellent, very solid. It's a full metal body with matte textured surface. Two side buttons here for shortcuts, and it's powered by one single 4A battery. The battery life will last for like months, so you can replace this very easily. You don't need pairing to use this stylus, it's always paired. For apps that allow only pen input for writing and drawing, you will get perfect palm rejection. So when you use your finger to write and draw, nothing will happen. In this case, the finger will pen the page. So you can rest your palm and write without the possibility of having stray strokes around the page. Even though the hinge is stiff, it's not stiff enough for you to have the tablet at an angle like this and rest your hand on it while you draw. So when it comes to drawing, I still have to use my proper stand. Time for some line quality test. So this is the diagonal line test. I'm trying to draw a straight diagonal line slowly, and I can see some wobble. So this is definitely going to affect accuracy. If you draw faster, the lines will be straight, but if you draw slow, there will be wobble with diagonal lines. This does not happen with vertical or horizontal lines, it's just with diagonal lines. Anyway, this performance that you see is very typical of Windows tablets, so this is actually not surprising to me. Let's draw some quick strokes to see if we can draw thin lines easily and how well the lines taper. So this Lenovo Digital Pen supports slightly over 4,000 levels of pressure sensitivity. Initial activation force is on the higher side, so you do have to press down slightly in order to get a line, but you can still draw thin lines, no problem. It's just that when you try to taper the lines, you can see the taper is not very smooth. The lines, they taper quite abruptly. So if you want to draw comic characters with hair, the lines are not going to taper that nicely. This is line transition from thin to thick. The transition is actually quite smooth, except here I'm actually drawing diagonal lines, so you can see the wobble again. And now I'm going to maintain consistent pressure to draw lines with consistent widths or thickness. It seems like I am able to maintain consistent pressure easily. By the way, any wobble that you see is due to the pen tip being quite slippery on the glass surface. The pen tip is quite slippery on this glass surface, so when it comes to drawing, sometimes it can be quite challenging, especially when you want to draw slower because you want to draw some details. If you need accuracy, sometimes you have to draw slower. In that case, it's quite challenging to draw slower on this display because the pen tip is quite slippery. When it comes to writing, having a slippery screen where the pen tip glides along very easily is not an issue, because when you are writing, you want to write fast and you can write really fast with this. Just that for drawing, the display is a bit too slippery for my liking. When it comes to drawing organic subjects like this, where you don't draw straight lines. The problem with the diagonal line jitter is not going to be that obvious, but if you need to draw with precision, for example, if you draw buildings or if you draw anything with straight lines, then diagonal line jitter is going to be an issue. It seems like the lines are tapering quite nicely now. So earlier on during the line test, the lines, they taper quite abruptly. Let me try again. Yep, they still taper quite abruptly. The lines tapering more smoothly here is due to me switching to a smaller brush. Let's draw a letterbox under the tree. When it comes to drawing horizontal and vertical lines, I don't have problems. But when drawing diagonal lines, if you want the lines to be straight, you have to draw a bit faster. If you draw slow like this, the lines could wobble. Here it doesn't seem too bad. But it's only because this is a very short line. The touch screen is very responsive, so you can use this to zoom in and out, pan and rotate. This app I'm using is MidiBang Paint Pro. This app also supports palm rejection, so if you use your finger to draw, nothing will happen. So the screen being this slippery makes it a bit challenging to draw subject matter that requires accuracy. So as I draw the straight lines, I can feel like there is wobble. Even though I'm drawing really fast, I can still feel the wobble because the pen tip is gliding way too smoothly on the surface. You may be wondering if you can actually apply a matte screen protector on the display to get that tactile feeling, to get a bit more friction to draw so that you get more control. You can do that, but it's also going to affect the image quality of the display. I guess it's possible to draw buildings, to draw subject matter that requires straight lines. It just needs, it will take some time to get used to drawing on this screen. Another issue I have with drawing and sometimes writing is I have the tendency to hit the side buttons accidentally. So when you hit this button, you call up this shortcut wheel. This shortcut wheel is quite useful if you need it. I hit the side button way too often when I'm drawing. The shortcuts here can be customized, and if you don't want this functionality, you can just turn this off using the Lenovo pen settings. Drawing performance will also depend on the apps you use, because with certain apps, they may actually use software to help smoothen the lines, to make the lines straighter. But with other apps that don't apply software correction, the lines can be a bit too wobbly for my liking, such as what you see here. But the main issue with this display when it comes to drawing is just how slippery it is. If there are felt tips or rubber tips available, it would greatly improve the drawing experience. This device is not targeted at digital artists, so I don't think I can fault this based on the drawing experience. Now, my overall experience when it comes to using this device is very positive. The Intel i7 processor together with 16 gigs of RAM makes this system feel very responsive. And the internal storage drive, the SSD, is also quite fast. So it's quick to start, restart. It's quick to save and load big files. Switching between apps is very responsive. You can have a lot of tabs open and the system will not lag. So this is a very responsive system. If you want to save some money, you can actually go with the Intel i5 model, which I think should still be more than powerful enough to handle all sorts of office type work like writing, surfing the web, running videos, or taking notes. Let's take a look at the pricing. So these are the prices that I found on Lenovo Singapore's website at the time of this review. There is the official pricing and the discounted pricing. In terms of pricing, it's actually quite competitive compared to competing devices with the same form factor. The pricing is actually very comparable or even better compared to the Microsoft Surface Pro 7. When you consider the Lenovo ThinkPad X12 actually includes 3 years on-site warranty and the keyboard cover is also included, but note that the pen, the stylus, is not included. Lenovo's pricing can sometimes be quite confusing. So if you take a look at this base model, it's priced at $2,379, but here it's listed at $3,000 and they give you a discount of $1,200. And then there is this item discount, whatever that is, and the add-on savings, whatever that is. This looks like the final price. And when I go to the checkout page, the price is actually lower compared to the big number just now. So to see the final price, you actually have to go to the last page of your order page. Another thing I want to show you is their warranty options. They have a lot of warranty options. So this pricing or that pricing includes 3 year warranty, on-site warranty. If you choose to drop down to the base warranty, which is just 1 year, it says here you can save $300 over. But the thing is, if you drop down to 1 year warranty, they would also remove the additional savings. So if you buy the base model with 3 year on-site warranty, the price is actually cheaper compared to the base model with 1 year basic warranty. It's weird. So Lenovo actually includes a lot of bundled savings with their warranty service. So this is the 3 year that is included. If you want to extend it to 4 or 5 years, these are the prices. For business users, if you want to keep your tablet for a longer time, I think this pricing is quite reasonable. In addition to extending the warranty period, there is also accidental damage protection for 3 years. Sealed battery replacement. This one you probably may need to get because the lithium battery inside usually will deteriorate over time. Like it may deteriorate 20% in terms of capacity year by year. So by the second year, you are probably left with 70% of the original battery capacity. So this one is probably worth the money. They also have backup service. This is $19, so this is not too bad as well. If you want to upgrade the specifications, the upgrade pricing is surprisingly reasonable. So I do not recommend getting the Intel i3 model, which is dual core. Definitely go with the Intel i5, which is quad core, and that is an extra $230. To upgrade the RAM from 8 gigs to 16 gigs, it's just $40, so that's really worth the money. And to upgrade the SSD storage from 256 to 512, that's an extra $70. Again, really worth the money. And to upgrade from 500 to 1 terabyte is an extra $200, which to me it's also worth the money. Because if you compare the upgrade pricing here to other brands, this is really very reasonable. To conclude, for drawing purposes, I do not recommend this because for the same amount of money, you can buy other tablets with better drawing performance. You can certainly draw on this, but you won't get the best experience. Now, for general purpose use, this is something I can recommend very easily because the build quality is fantastic for both the tablet and the keyboard. The keyboard is really nice to type on. The trackpad works really well. This keyboard cover is excellent. The display looks good. The colors look good. It has good brightness, and the Intel 11th gen processor for this year, the 11th gen Intel processors, they are quite good, quite efficient. They are powerful enough to handle all sorts of work, surfing the web, doing documents, using Microsoft Office, even video editing. If you want to, you can do it. So overall performance is very smooth without any lag. Battery life is quite reasonable. For the Intel i7 model, I got 7 hours of battery life. Personally, I would go with the Intel i5 model because it's cheaper and you get longer battery life. And the pricing is very competitive compared to other brands offering the same form factor. And the upgrade pricing for the RAM and for the SSD storage is really reasonable. That is actually quite surprising to me because a lot of manufacturers like to rip off their customers by giving them the base unit and then forcing them to pay like very expensive prices for upgrades, but not with Lenovo. So thank goodness for that. And the pricing is inclusive of 3 years on-site warranty where repairs are done on the next business day. So their employees would come down to your location to fix things for you. Convenience. The downsides, audio quality, not that great. There's no micro SD card slot and the pen is not included, but this is not that expensive to buy. So this is my review of the Lenovo ThinkPad X12 detachable. This is something I can recommend very easily for anyone who needs a computing device with this form factor. If you guys have any questions, let me know in the comment section below. And do check out the links for where you can buy this in the video description. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.